You are attending computer coding class.
Welcome. Today we will learn how to use ternary operator in Python. Ternary operator is also known as a conditional operator that evaluate an expression based on a condition being true or false. It was added in Python version 2.5. The benefit of this operator is that in place of multi-line if-else statements, we will write a single line statement. So the code is very small, compact, and save the processing time. This is the syntax. First syntax is for ternary operator in C, C++, and Java. Here we don't use any if-else. Here expression means test condition. If test condition is true, then cursor goes on true statement. Otherwise, the cursor goes to on false statement. We use question mark after the test condition and colon in between true and false statements. But in Python, we don't use question mark and colon. Here we use if and else. First cursor goes to if and check the test condition. If condition is true, then cursor goes to on true statement. Otherwise cursor goes to else statements. First I will show implementation of ternary operator in C++ using code block editor. I will create a program to find maximum of two values. Then I will implement the ternary operator in Python using spider editor and calculate maximum of two values so that you can compare both the ternary operator in different languages. In Python, I will implement ternary operator in 9 different ways. There is a big deal in Python. First of all, we will open the code block editor and start to create a program in C++. First, include header file iostream, then another library files like cout and cin. Then create the main block. In main block, first we will declare all the variables in integer. First one is a, second one is b, and third one is max. Then we will input both the values by using cin command. Then we will write the our ternary operator expression. Here we will not use any if else. Max here is a variable that holds the maximum value. After max, we will write equal to for assignment. Then in parentheses, we will write the test condition. A is greater than equal to B. Then question mark. And then we will write both the value A and B. And in between A and B, we use the colon. At last, we will print out the maximum value by using cout operator. This is the implementation of ternary operator in C++. We have created the program. Now we will compile and run the program. There is no error. So we will input both the values. Here I am inserting 6 and 7 as A and B, and it is printing maximum value as 7. I think that now you have understand the implementation of ternary operator in C++. Now we will write the program in spider editor using Python interpreter. In Python, first I will create a program to calculate maximum of two values using if else block. Here I will not use ternary operator in first program. In this program, first we will input both the values and store in A and B variables. Now we will write if else condition. If A is greater than equal to B, then maximum equal to A, else max equal to B. This is the simplest form of if else conditional block. And last, we will print the maximum value max. Now run the program. First we will input value for A and B, that is 7 and 4, and it is displaying maximum value 7. This is the simplest form of if else. Now we will convert this multi-line if else block into a single line using ternary operator, that is called simple method of ternary operator. In ternary operator, first we will write true statement, then write if. After if, we will write test condition, and then we will write else, and after else we will write false statement. This is the implementation of ternary operator in Python. Now run the program. We have already printed the maximum value here. First we will input first value as an A, that is 8. Second value is 3. So the maximum value is 8. Again we are running the same program and inserting 6 as first value and 17 as second value, and it is showing 17 as a maximum value. Next method is called direct method. Here we will implement ternary operator using dictionary. I will create a dictionary that holds two values with two keys. First value is A and its key is true, and second value is B and its key is false. After dictionary, we will write test condition in bracket, that is A is greater than equal to B. Here cursor first goes to test condition. If A is greater than B, then it will return true, and enter in dictionary. Here true means A value. If condition is false, then in a dictionary it will return B value. Now run the program and enter both the values 7 and 8, and it is showing maximum value is 8. Next we will apply direct method using tuple in place of dictionary. First we will create a tuple. This tuple holds two values. First value is false value. It means on zero index we will write false value, and in first index we will write true value. If condition is true, then the condition will return 1. It means true value will be printed. And if condition is false, it means it will return 0 value. So in tuple, the value at 0 index will be returned and assigned to max variable. Now run the program. Enter the value of A as 6 and B 8. The maximum value is 8. Again we run the program and input both the values for A and B. First value is 9 and second value is 2. So the maximum value is 9. Now we will implement ternary operator using binary logical operators that are called Boolean operators. Logical or and logical and operator. Here first we will write the test condition, that is A is greater than equal to B. Then we will write and logical operator. Then we will write first value, that is A. After A we will write second logical operator or, and then we will write the value B. Here concept is that if condition is true, then first operand will be returned, and if condition is false, then second operand will be returned. Next, we will implement ternary operator using lambda functions. In this implementation, first of all, we will create a tuple and insert two lambda functions in this tuple. At zero position, we will insert lambda b function, and at position one, we will place lambda a function. So if test condition is true, then this will return one value. So in tuple, the value of lambda function at position one will be return, and if the condition is false, then it will return zero. So the value at index zero will be returned and assigned to max. Now run the program and insert two value 6 and 9, and it is printing the maximum value 9. Again we are running the program. Next we are inserting 8 and 2, and it is printing maximum value 8. This is the implementation of lambda function in ternary operator. Next we will implement ternary operator using print function. In print function, first of all we will write true condition, then we will write if, after if we will write test condition, and then else and false condition. Now directly we will run the program. Enter first value a equal to 7, b value 8, and it is printing 8 is maximum value. So it is also correct ternary operator using print function. Next operator is nested ternary operator using print function. Here we will check third condition also, that is if both a and b are equal. Here first we will check whether a and b both are equal. If both are equal, then we will just print the statement a and b are equal. If a and b are not equal, then we will enter in else condition. In else condition, we will check whether a is greater than b. If a is greater than b, then we will print a is maximum. And in else condition, where a is less than b, then we will print b is maximum. Here we are just writing an inner if else block in outer else block. Now we will run the program and check all three conditions. First condition, where both a and b are equal. Second condition, where a is greater than b. And third condition, where b is greater than a. For better understanding of nested ternary operator, now we will write the same condition without using any ternary operator. First, we will write outer if condition where a equal to b. If this condition is true, then we will print a and b are equal. Then we will write the outer else conditional block. In outer else block, we will write another inner block. In this inner block, we will write the first condition where we will check if a is greater than b. If this condition is true, then print maximum value is a. Okay, now in else condition, it means b is greater than a. Here we will print maximum equal to b. So this is the nested condition. Here without using nested ternary operator, we had to write 7 lines. But when we use ternary operator, we just wrote the whole statements in a single line. This is the benefit of ternary operator among others operator. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel Computer Coding Class. Thank you.